Greetings. Continuing our dissection and exposure of the lies and errors in Deedat's combat kit against God's people. Let's continue with 3a. Abraham. He wedded his own sister, Sarah. Point A. Why saidest thou, O Abraham, she is my sister, so I might have taken her to be my wife? Now take her, Sarah, and go thy way. Genesis 12:19. So the basic accusation Deedat makes is, Abraham married his sister. Or Deedat is so confused he is trying to claim the Torah says, Abraham married his sister. Now this is one of those examples where Deedat proves he cannot read and comprehend language. Whether by ignorance or mental retardation or willful deception, I cannot say. But we can certainly prove, and easily, that Deedat was wrong. So let's go look at the Torah and see what it really says in context. Chapter 12. Now the Lord had said unto Abram, Get thee out of thy country, and from thy kindred, and from thy father's house, unto a land that I will show thee. And I will make of thee a great nation, and I will bless thee, and make thy name great, and thou shalt be a blessing. And I will bless them that bless thee, and curse them that curse thee. And in thee shall all families of the earth be blessed. So Abram departed as the Lord had spoken unto him, and Lot went with him, and Abraham was 75 years old when he departed out of Haran. And Abraham took Sarah his wife, and Lot his brother's son, and all their substance that they had gathered, and the souls they had gotten in Haran, and they went forth to go into the land of Canaan, and into the land of Canaan they came. And Abraham passed through the land unto the place of Sichem, unto the plain of Moreh. And the Canaanite was then in the land. And the Lord appeared unto Abram and said, Unto thy seed will I give this land. And there built he an altar unto the Lord, who appeared unto him. And he removed from thence unto a mountain on the east of Bethel, and pitched his tent, having Bethel on the west and Hai on the east. And there he built an altar unto the Lord, and called upon the name of the Lord. And Abraham journeyed, going on still toward the south. And there was a famine in the land, and Abram went down into Egypt to sojourn there, for the famine was grievous in the land. And it came to pass, when he was come near to enter into Egypt, that he said unto Sarah his wife, Behold now, I know that thou art a fair woman to look upon. Therefore, it shall come to pass, when the Egyptians shall see thee, they will say, This is his wife, and they will kill me, but they will save you alive. Say, I pray thee, thou art my sister, that it may be well with me for your sake, and my soul shall live because of you. And it came to pass that when Abraham was come into Egypt, the Egyptians beheld the woman, that she was very fair. The princes also of Pharaoh saw her, and commended her before Pharaoh. And the woman was taken into Pharaoh's house. And he entreated Abraham well for her sake. And he had sheep, and oxen, and asses, and men servants, and maid servants, and she asses, and camels. Entreated him well. Pharaoh wanted Sarah. And the Lord plagued Pharaoh and his house with great plagues because of Sarah, Abram's wife. And Pharaoh called Abram and said, What is this that thou hast done unto me? Why didst thou not tell me she was thy wife? Why saidest thou, She is my sister, so that I might have taken her to me to wife? Now therefore, behold thy wife, take her, and go thy way. Do you understand the whole story now? Allow me to briefly review. Sarah was beautiful. So beautiful that Abram said, They will kill me to have you. And so Abraham asked Sarah to say she was only his sister. Nowhere in this text does it say Sarah was the sister of Abraham. And I am not getting into the issue of Abraham giving Sarah away. He was an old man of 75, and he was afraid. And when they got to Egypt, it says the Egyptians did notice her, so much that they took her from Abraham. And when Pharaoh figures it out, he goes to Abraham and says, "Why did you say she was only your sister?" So think about this. Nowhere in this text does it say Sarah was the sister of Abraham. And yet Deedat teaches lies to you Mohammedans. Lies to get you to hate the Torah. And worse, to hate the God of the Torah. Oh Muslim, please ponder and answer me one question. What kind of man tells such bold-faced lies about the Torah? Think about it. Why is Deedat teaching such lies in his combat kit? He wedded his own sister, Sarah. Do you understand what these words mean, O Mohammedan? He wedded his own sister, Sarah. Please stop and think until you do understand, O Mohammedan. He wedded his own sister, Sarah. This is the claim Deedat makes in his combat kit. Now it is not clear what the little question mark means. For all we know, it may be Deedat's admission he was ignorant and could not figure out this simple story. But what does Deedat leave as his text description? He wedded his own sister, Sarah, and nothing could be further from the truth. Except perhaps Deedat claiming Abraham gave birth to Muhammad? And I hope that some of you in Islam might catch the error in that statement without me. These are serious and damning problems in the combat kit, my friend. Deedat and Islam lie to you when they make such claims attacking the Torah. And they think that you are stupid and lazy, my friend. Islam and Deedat think you are too stupid to catch their lies. Islam and Deedat think you are too lazy to check their lies. And I have to ask you, if you dare think you are Muslim, how can you submit to God when you tolerate liars? How can you think you are on the right path when your guides are liars? But that begs another question. Do you even care? Do you even care that Islam tolerates and venerates a proven liar like Deedat? Do you dare say you care? Actually care? But that begs another question. How long will you continue to follow liars like Deedat and those who spread his lies? Time is short. And Almighty God has sent me as a warner to you, O Muslim. For the mystery of iniquity does already work. Only he who now lets will let until he is taken out of the way. And then shall that wicked be revealed, whom the Lord shall consume with the spirit of his mouth, and shall destroy with the brightness of his coming. Even him whose coming is after the working of Satan, with all power and signs and lying wonders, and with all deceivableness of unrighteousness in them that perish, because they received not the love of the truth, that they might be saved. Allow yourself to receive the love of the truth, and for this cause God shall send them strong delusion, that they should believe a lie. That they all might be damned who believed not the truth, but had pleasure in unrighteousness. Listen, God says if you don't love the truth, you have pleasure in unrighteousness. The strong delusion is coming, and nothing will seal your heart more than you thinking you are right. When Issa of Islam appears and claims to be Muslim, I believe that event will seal the hearts and damn those who do not care for the truth. Love the truth. Seek the truth. Search for it like a pearl of great price. Do not just take what I say without checking. Be good Bereans. Search the Word of God daily to see if what I say is true. May the Spirit of God open your eyes to the light, your ears to the truth, and your heart to His Son, the Lord Jesus Christ. Amen.